The approachable visualizations and motion graphics in this video will unlock your understanding of fetch and pull. You'll learn the theory behind these two operations, see live code samples, and review the three most common Git pull configuration options. Let's start high level. Under the hood, the Git pull command is simply a shortcut for Git fetch followed by Git merge. Git fetch downloads commits from a remote repository, and Git merge incorporates those commits into your local repository. Let's take a peek at what that looks like in practice. Let's say I have a Git repository stored on a Git hosting service, like GitHub. I'll grab a clone of this repository, and as you can see, both the local and remote repositories share a branch named main. Since I'm not the only person contributing to this repository, other collaborators are also free to push changes. For example, let's say this blue commit here was added by another collaborator. In order to download this commit, I'd run fetch. Fetching transfers new commits from a remote repository into my local clone. However, as you can see in the visualization, even after fetching, my local main branch hasn't changed. It still references a commit behind the new one we just downloaded. In order to actually incorporate that new commit into my local branch, I need to follow up that fetch with a merge. Running git merge will update my main branch pointer to reference that latest commit. So, as you can see, incorporating new remote changes is actually two distinct git operations, first fetching and then merging. If you want more details on fetching and merging, check out my last video on Git collaboration basics. But what about using Git pull in this scenario instead? Well, let's rewind our example. Now, when I'm ready to download that new remote change, I'll run Git pull instead of fetch. This time, the new commit is downloaded and my local main branch is updated all at the same time. Pretty convenient. At a high level, this is the difference between fetch and pull. But what's the point of using fetch if you always need to merge afterwards anyways? Why not use pull all the time? Well, the answer really comes down to having control and transparency in certain situations. Let me explain. Let's say we've just added a new commit locally, this pink one here. At the same time, another collaborator added theirs remotely, this blue one here. When I fetch, my local main and remote main branches are going to diverge. I then need to decide how to reconcile this situation. I could either use a standard three-way merge, or I could even reach for rebase to replay my local commit on top of that new commit. However, both solutions result in side effects, either the creation of a merge commit or rewriting history. Because git pull is fetching and merging all in one, you need to specify how to handle a divergent scenario like this prior to actually pulling, and this can be a little tricky. It's hard to know the best way to reconcile local with remote changes without first downloading and examining them. This and side effects are a big downside, and that's why you'll hear some experienced software engineers recommend against using pull in favor of fetching and merging manually. That said, there are a few common merging strategies that typically are paired with pull, and they can help streamline this process. Let's take a look. The three most common are fast forward only, fast forward, and rebase. As you can see by looking at the pull command, you specify these using command line flags. Whichever method you specify is what pull will use to merge local and remote changes. But let's break these down and see examples of each side by side. And let's start here on the right with rebase. When I execute git pull --rebase, Git will download the new remote commit and use rebase to copy and then replay any local commits on top of the new change. As you can see in the visualization, our Git history has been rewritten such that it appears all my local development happened after the commits from remote, even though they all happened at the same time. This is a clean and convenient option because it bypasses the need to add an extra merge commit. This is probably the most popular option, but there are pros and cons to using rebase, so check out my dedicated rebase video if you need more information. Next, let's move on to the --ff option. The full syntax is git pull --ff, and when I execute this command, Git will download the new commits and start a standard merge. Since this operation will result in a merge commit, Git is going to prompt you to provide a commit message. My default terminal text editor is Vim, so I can actually edit the message by hitting I to enter insert mode and then typing my own message. I can then hit escape colon WQ, which will save and exit the editor. This will prompt Git to finalize the merge. As with any merge, there's also a chance for conflicts, so see my video on resolving merge conflicts if you do happen to come across that scenario. Then lastly, we have the --ff only option. For this example, if I were to run git pull with this option, Git would download the new commit, but as you can see in the output, stop short of actually performing any sort of merge. This is because fast forward only will not create any new commits or rewrite history by itself. If it detects divergent changes, it will stop and let you handle those merges on your own. This is very convenient and great for beginners because it gives you a chance to examine the remote changes and decide the best way to proceed at your own pace. The only time fast forward only will actually perform a merge is if a fast forward merge is possible. As a quick refresher, a fast forward merge happens when the target branch has not diverged from the source branch. Now, in this context, that simply means you have no new commits locally that could cause conflicts with fetched remote changes. The fast forward only option would complete this merge by simply fast forwarding the local main branch to the tip of the new changes, just like you saw at the very beginning of the video. If you're new to Git, I'd recommend using the fast forward only option almost exclusively. Plus, in newer versions of Git, running Git pull without arguments will prompt you to set a default merging strategy. I'd recommend setting this to fast forward only, and after setting this, you're safe to simply run Git pull without any arguments, knowing that it's going to run fast forward only behind the scenes. And that's all you really need to know about Git pull and how it relates to fetch, but let's quickly review. Git pull is simply Git fetch followed by a Git merge behind the scenes. And when you're using pull, you have the option to specify a merging strategy. The three most popular are fast forward only, fast forward, and rebase. Fast forward only will fetch new commits, but only merge if there are no new local changes. Fast forward stands for fast forward optional and will create a merge commit if the local and remote branches diverge. Lastly, rebase reorders local commits so that they appear after fetch remote changes. And that'll about do it for our crash course on fetching and pulling. But Git collaboration can be a deep topic with nuance and detail not particularly well suited for a platform like YouTube. So if you're curious to go deeper, you can find comprehensive lessons on my dedicated learning platform, learngit.io. And just like my YouTube channel, all the lessons on LearnGit feature motion graphics, but they're just far more in depth. And to give a little credit to those who made it all the way to the end of this video, I'll leave a discount code in the description, valid for the next 24 hours. If you missed this window, be sure to subscribe and turn on notifications so you won't miss my next one. Thanks, hopefully this was helpful, and I'll see you next time.